Eliminating the barriers for AI adoption. We're here at AWS reInvent in Las Vegas, and I'm here with Sharad Kumar. You're the CTO, field CTO for Qlik, for data. And one of the key parts is data. So can you explain what is one of the key barriers where data plays the important role for being ready for AI?
Yeah. So if you look at AI adoption is generally on the rise. It's been given a boost with Gen AI. And the one most important thing about Gen AI is companies now have access to pre-built models off the shelf. So you don't have to do the hard work of creating a model, training it. You don't require a lot of data science expertise. You don't require a lot of data. You don't require a lot of infrastructure because you can acquire these models. So what differentiates you now is your data. If everybody has the same model, how are you any different? It's your data. Also, these models are not capable of answering questions about your data because they're not trained on your data. So you have to marry your data with these models. So the differentiator is the data. So now you need to make sure your data is what we call AI ready. That's ready for consumption by these AI models, right? So, so the multiple things then go into the readiness of AI. So, so data is more is very important for AI. You cannot have AI without data. It was already true before because you needed data to build models. But now in this new world, both structured data and unstructured data is very critical because without that, you cannot take advantage of the power of generative AI.
Yeah, and you're going to give a keynote where you're going to talk about the data producers and the consumers and where there's a gap between these two, which is one of the key barriers. Can you explain that?
Yeah, so it's a couple of things, right? So one, you need to get your data ready, like I said, for AI. And that means multiple things, readiness of data. First thing you need to do is you need to get the data out of these different silos that are there and need to bring the data, structured data, unstructured data, and bring it together and integrate it together. Then you need to make sure the data is very timely. So, so it's very important for AI models to make the timely decision. You need to make sure your data is near real time. So let's put a new focus on timeliness of data. So you need to make sure data is timely. You need to make sure data is good quality. If you train your model on bad quality data, you get bad results. If you have bad data, you'll get bad answers from your chatbots or agents. So quality of data. There's a lot of discussion, if you look in the press, is about the security of data. So if you have sensitive data, corporate data, which is PII or corporate sensitive data, trade secret data, and you build models on it, the data could get leaked through it. So you got to protect that data. Then you need to make sure data has all the right context from a business so people can understand what it means. And then you got to finally shape it into a form. So all of these, we have these six principles of AI readiness, we call. So you have to make sure the data producers can create data with all these six principles so that it can be consumed by analytic ready applications.
Yes, and if your data is ready with these six principles, you can build data products.
Yes.
What does that mean?
Yes, yeah. So, so data products is kind of a new concept. It's bringing really product thinking to data. So rather than putting all the onus on central IT, which a lot of the old architectures are built where central IT takes data and loads it into a platform like a data lake or a warehouse. But what happens is these projects are not done with business in mind or use cases in mind. So data products is kind of a new concept where you have data product teams which are aligned to domains and business. And they're the ones who create these data products along the six principles we talk about. So there's ownership and accountability for it, right? And that's the most important thing that is missing in data environments today, ownership and accountability. So you'd ask, who's responsible for quality of the data? So when I go and talk to a lot of different organizations and I'm in a room and I ask, who owns this data? Nobody raises their hand. Or maybe a data engineer sitting in the corner of the room will raise their hand, which is the wrong answer, right? Because data should not be owned by an engineer or an IT person. It's a business ownership. And that's what data products do, because data product teams are made up of individuals from both business and IT, all working together. And they are the ones who can create data products which adhere to these six principles of AI readiness.
And can you give a quick example from a client who's using it this way?
Yeah, so if you look at just even what we what I'm going to talk in the keynote is if you look at SAP aligned data products, you can think of data products as order data product. You can think of it as a billing data product, a receivable data products. So then I can do my analysis, things like I want to build supply chain optimization, or I want to build a forecasting, demand forecasting, or I want to do my order to cash analytics. These users who want to build these analytics, they can very quickly go find these data products in the marketplace. They know all these six principles are adhered to. That means the data is the latest and the freshest data, is good quality, it can be trusted, and it's easily consumable, so they can build their analytics using these data products.
And which is in this case done by the teams themselves.
Yeah, done by the team. So the data product teams create these data products, and data consumers who are building these analytics and AI-driven applications can self-serve themselves by finding these data products in the marketplace and consuming them directly.
And making companies make their data ready for AI.
Yes, Sharad, absolutely.
Thanks a lot.
Thank you, Ron.
And thank you for watching here from the AWS reInvent in Vegas from the Qlik booth, where we're going to watch your show.
Yes.
Thank you. Thanks. Yep.